There is going to be a negotiation about Brexit or to reach an agreement, but at what cost? I'm rather optimistic. I believe there is going to be an agreement. We'll see in the next hours, but I believe it is reasonable to imagine an agreement that will allow Prime Minister Cameron to face and, as we all hope, win June's referendum, or whenever it's going to be. The other main topic is immigration. Austria is closing the borders. Is a European strategy still lacking? Do you want to make progress on this? I hope so, because a year ago this topic was only an Italian topic. Slowly, day by day, drop after drop, we convinced the European institutions to engage on this topic, that it is an all-time event which won't last days, but months, or years. This needs a European strategy. Austria has a position that is understandably hard, because we are talking about a country that, can you believe it, had more asylum seekers than Italy in terms of the number of applications. And Austria is a country that's much smaller than Italy and with a smaller population. There is indeed an Austrian theme on this issue. However, we can't even think about closing the Brennero tunnel. That's symbolically, but not only symbolically, one of Europe's main points of union. Thus, we have to work together. I think it's necessary to do what I've always said. That is, we need to have one strategy from the beginning. We need international investment and cooperation, and investments in the leaving countries of the migrants. That in some countries will be diplomatic investments, such as in Syria and Iraq. In others, like in Africa, will be economical investments. I think that they have been starting to understand that this is not only an Italian issue, it's everybody's issue. In theory, there are already answers. Let's see if in practice we'll manage to do another step forward. What will happen if the Balkan route is closed? Is Italy ready for another mass arrival of refugees? It's crystal clear that we need to work so that there won't be an emergency situation in the Balkans. It won't be easy. However, Italy is always ready to do its duty. But the real question today is Europe ready to do its duty? And the aim of this European summit is precisely this, to understand if we're moving from a tactical attitude of short-term solutions to a strategic attitude where there are long-term plans. Some countries keep referring to the Dublin Convention, where first arrival countries have to sustain a majority of the load. What's your position on this? To those of us who live in the real world, 2015 was the year where everybody saw that Dublin didn't work. And also the request that is coming from the Austrians is to activate the systems of relocation and the systems of repatriations. I think that the real answer here is one of those saying Europe must be the one managing not only relocations of the asylum seekers in the member states, but also the repatriations. We are the country that made more repatriations than anybody else. If you look at the chart, Italy has been the country that has repatriated the most people. But instead of only Italy, it's Europe that should manage the repatriations. And together with Europe, there should be investment in international cooperation with some of these countries, maybe providing training courses to approach some of these people. I think, for instance, in the agricultural sector. With this, I'm referring particularly to Africa, but not only to Africa. Thus, if you make a common European strategy, it's evident that things will work much better. So, Dublin failed. It's obvious to everyone. Then, there may be some colleagues that for national regions don't agree with this. Well, that's part of the rule of politics, but this is the objective truth. You'll see this migration issue at the European Summit and the future European summits, in the next one and in the June summit. For years, it was thought that we'd be able to sweep this issue under the carpet. Now we see that it is a priority. What I think is going to be very interesting for the next European summit is that either if Dublin will officially be dismantled or not, the real truth is that Dublin doesn't work anymore, and everyone knows that. Thank you.
Dublino è fallito. Dublino ha fallito. È sotto gli occhi di tutti. Che poi ci siano alcuni colleghi che per motivi comprensibili interni vogliono dire il contrario, questo sta nelle regole della politica, ma il dato di fatto è che oggi il Consiglio europeo e nei prossimi Consigli europei, perché questa storia della migrazione la vedrete anche al prossimo Consiglio europeo, la vedrete a quello di giugno, per anni si è fatto finta che non ci fosse, si è pensato di nascondere la polvere sotto il tappeto, adesso vediamo che invece è una priorità, quello che io credo che sarà molto interessante per i prossimi Consigli europei è che sia che venga formalmente sancita la fine di Dublino, sia che non venga formalmente detto, la verità dei fatti è che Dublino non funziona più e lo sanno tutti. Grazie.